We are here at the Arabian Travel Market, and with me I have Mr. Mohamed Nazri, who is the Minister of Tourism and Culture for Malaysia. Mr. Nazri, welcome to Dubai.
Mr.
Nazri, the Middle East market is an important market for Malaysia, contributing as much as 2.6 million ringgit to the Malaysian economy. How do you see the Middle East market developing for Malaysia in the coming years?
Yes, the Middle East market is a very important market for us. And as you rightly said, it has contributed about 2.6 billion ringgit, which is about the same with two reals and all that. And it is growing, And but unfortunately, because of the fall in the price of oil and gas, we saw a slight dip in the tourism receipts, which is down about 2.1% compared to 2015. In terms of arrival also, we have about 287,000 from the West Asia, Middle East. And that is down by 9.1% in terms of arrival. But we are not deterred by these figures because overall, actually the West Asian market are the biggest spender, And of course, our forte will be the halal, tourism, the food, the cuisine. As you know, Middle East travelers are very conservative, they're Muslim. So we market ourselves as a family tourism destination. And we have families coming to Malaysia. And because West Asians are mostly Muslim, so our halal tourism ensures that you'll be given halal food. And in fact, in Malaysia, most of the hotels and the restaurant in Malaysia, they are halal. Unless, of course, you go to the hotel or the restaurant where it says that it's not halal, then you can be rest assured that everything is halal. So I think this is the advantage of Malaysia in terms of West Asian tourists, because we give them the comfort of knowing that, you know, our destination is family, and also everything is halal in Malaysia. Yeah.
Talking about tourist arrivals from the Middle East to Malaysia, Malaysia recently announced a new policy of providing visa-free travel, not only for nationals from certain Middle East countries, but as well as expatriates with a valid residence visa residing. How do you see the impact of this move in the coming years?
Thank you very much for reminding me of this, because when I was in India with Prime Minister Najib on his official visit to India about 3 weeks ago, Prime Minister Najib announced that for all Indian nationals and the NRIs, regardless where they are, as long as they hold Indian passport, they can come to Malaysia on a new scheme we call the e-visa, whereby all Indian nationals can go to Malaysia for 30 days, multiple entry. And it's e-visa. You don't have to go to the embassy of Malaysia to get your visa. It's online, and you just need to pay processing fee, that's all, for 25 USD. So with this, we hope that we do know that in the Middle East, there are many Indian expatriates. They are the biggest, I think, in the Middle East. And we are making easy for them to come to Malaysia. And we expect coming from the Middle East next year, there will be an increase. We're hoping that we can get about 350,000 for the year 2017 with the new announcement of the new visa scheme for Indian citizens. Middle East tourists, as you all know, that it's visa free. They just come to Malaysia and they get 30 days. So with this, we hope the numbers of tourists coming from Middle East will increase, because they expect we fly directly from Middle East direct to Kuala Lumpur.
In the backdrop of very reduced travel and tourism activities because of the economic crisis all across the world, what steps is Malaysia planning to take to boost its tourism industry in the near future?
Yes, I think we will continue to advertise in the national TV. You know that we are on CNN, but now we intend to go into national TV of each country. This is to create awareness amongst the tourists, because when there's a decrease in the number as a result of the oil and gas price, we need to advertise more and to advertise Malaysia as a very competitive tourism market. In fact, the World Economic Forum has recently announced that Malaysia is the third cheapest country which provide touristic destination in Malaysia. We are the third cheapest. So this we need to inform the public, especially in the Middle East, because the fear amongst them is that because the oil and gas has gone down, they fear that, you know, they don't have enough money to spend overseas. But no, in Malaysia it is still cheap. Even with a certain amount of money, you can really get your money's worth if you travel and spend your time and holidays in Malaysia.
The Malaysian embassy in Abu Dhabi had initiated a project of publishing a special business and tourism guide to Malaysia to target the Middle East travelers. How do you see what do you see the role of these kind of specialized publications in promoting bilateral tourism ties between Malaysia and the UAE in general, in particular, and the Middle East in general?
Yeah, that's very important, because in Malaysia we have the MICEP, which is the Malaysian Convention Exhibition Bureau. And of course, when we have this new arrangement in UAE, we expect more businessmen to come, not only invest in Malaysia, but also to bring their family and attend all these conferences in Malaysia. And as I've said, Middle East are very conservative, and our country is a very family-oriented tourism. And with this new arrangement, I expect to see more Middle East businessmen coming with their family and spending more time in Malaysia.
Thank you so much, Dr. Nazir, and we wish you luck in your endeavors. And we wish to visit Malaysia soon. Thank you so much. Thank you so much.